Have you ever wondered how the world's biggest engineering achievements are accomplished before modern technology? How did workers build canals that connected oceans, bridges that spanned mighty rivers, or entire cities on barren landscapes? Behind every great human attempt lies an array of powerful machines, massive, steam-powered creatures that laid the foundation of modern society. These weren't just tools, they were innovators that shaped our cities, industries, and even our future. Today, we will know the history of these iron giants. The steam shovels, excavators, draglines, and cranes that made impossible tasks possible. These machines moved more than just dirt, they moved history. Introduced in 1909, the Ruston Hooley steam navvy shovel revolutionized British quarries and construction. This 12-ton machine replaced labor-intensive digging with steam-powered precision, transforming how large-scale excavation projects were completed. It played an important role in Britain's rapid industrial expansion, helping build railways and infrastructure, and supporting the growing empire, all at a fraction of the cost of manual labor. After decades abandoned in a Bedfordshire quarry, the navvy was rediscovered in 1977 by historian Ray Hooley. Restored and now displayed at the Threlkeld Quarry and Mining Museum, it stands as a tribute to the early 20th century steam technology that powered Britain's industrial growth. The Ruston Hooley steam navvy wasn't just a technological marvel, it was a tool of transformation. It played an important role in mechanizing construction, turning Britain into an industrial powerhouse. Its restoration and preservation provide us with a glance into the industrial past that built modern-day infrastructure. The steam cranes at Chatham Dockyard were important to Britain's naval power, especially during World War II. Designed by Grafton Cranes Limited, these cranes handled heavy lifting that manual labor couldn't manage. Their locomotive design allowed them to move across 17 miles of track, providing flexibility in transporting ship parts and machinery throughout the dockyard. Powered by steam, they lifted everything from raw materials to massive ship components with precision, ensuring the rapid repair and assembly of warships. These cranes were essential in maintaining Britain's naval superiority during the war, contributing not only to logistics, but also to the morale of the workforce, ensuring Britain's naval power through their strength, precision, and adaptability. Over in Erie, Pennsylvania, a new chapter in industrial machinery was developing. The Erie Steam Shovel Company, founded in the early 20th century, quickly became renowned for its steam-powered excavators. Their models, like the 20-ton Type B and the 13-ton Type A, were among the first fully revolving steam shovels, offering operators 360-degree movement, a revolutionary feature at the time. These early models became the gold standard for heavy-duty excavation, particularly in railroad ditching and open trench excavation. Their ability to be mounted on crawlers, steel resistance wheels, or railroad tracks made them versatile and highly adaptable to various terrains and conditions. In 1927, the Erie Steam Shovel Company merged with Bucyrus, forming Bucyrus Erie, a global leader in excavation equipment. These machines were essential in shaping early 20th century infrastructure projects in the US and abroad. Although Bucyrus Erie didn't dominate the Panama Canal project like Bucyrus, the Erie shovel still played a role in massive industrial efforts, leaving a lasting mark on the excavation industry. The Erie steam shovel helped standardize small excavator technology, providing a reliable and efficient tool for the construction, mining, and railroad industries. Its innovations in revolving shovels laid the groundwork for modern-day excavation technology. Perhaps no machine is iconic in the history of large-scale engineering projects as the Bucyrus steam shovels. When the United States took over the construction of the Panama Canal in 1904, it faced one of the most disconcerting engineering tasks of the era. The challenge was enormous, to move millions of tons of earth and rock through dense jungle and mountainous land. For this task, the Americans turned to Bucyrus, who supplied 77 of the 102 steam shovels used in the project. The 95-ton shovels with their 5 cubic yard buckets were the workhorses of the canal, able to move up to 8 tons of material in one scoop. These machines operated 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, clearing some of the most difficult sections of the canal, such as the notorious Culebra Cut. By 1913, when the canal was finally completed, Bucyrus shovels had moved a staggering amount of earth, enabling one of the most significant feats of engineering in human history. Despite floods, landslides, and dangerous working conditions, the Bucyrus shovels kept going, setting records for earth removal and outpacing the workforce's ability to transport the material. Without them, the Panama Canal may have taken decades longer to complete, fundamentally altering the course of global trade. The Bucyrus steam shovels helped build the Panama Canal, which drastically shortened shipping routes and changed global commerce forever. These machines set a new standard for industrial excavation and proved that mechanization could conquer even the toughest natural obstacles. During World War II, Britain was in desperate need of industrial resources to fuel its war machine. Enter the excavator shovel, a massive piece of equipment that weighed over 140 tons and could move 4 tons of limestone with each bucket. These shovels were essential in digging out limestone for cement production, used to build everything from military bunkers to airplane hangars. The machine's capacity wasn't just limited to the war effort. After the war, it played a crucial role in reclaiming millions of acres of farmland. Britain needed to grow more food, and the excavator shovel helped drain swamps, dig irrigation ditches, and prepare land for cultivation. It's no exaggeration to say that this machine helped feed a nation while also powering its war production. The excavator shovel wasn't just a tool for construction. It was a symbol of strength during Britain's darkest hours. Its ability to serve both military and agricultural needs highlights its versatility and importance in keeping Britain self-sufficient during the war. Standing at a massive 1,000 tons, the dragline excavator was a marvel of engineering. What made it truly unique was its ability to walk, a slow, deliberate process that allowed this beast to move along pits and fields as it stripped away topsoil and extracted valuable minerals. This walking feature, combined with its 100-foot-long boom and 5-ton bucket, made it one of the most powerful excavation tools in existence. Draglines were especially useful in surface mining, where their reach and power could remove enormous amounts of material in a single sweep. From coal mining to quarrying, these machines were vital in extracting the raw materials that fueled industrial growth. Even today, modern versions of the dragline excavator are used in mining operations worldwide. The dragline excavator didn't just dig, it walked. This revolutionary design allowed it to cover more ground than other excavation machines, making it essential for industries where large-scale earthmoving was required. Its ability to remove vast amounts of overburden in mining operations helped fuel the energy needs of industrialized nations. First introduced in 1923, the Bucyrus Erie 50B steam shovel was a massive machine that weighed 130,000 pounds and boasted a 75-ton capacity. It was one of the first heavy-duty, 360-degree rotating shovels to be mounted on crawler tracks, giving it unprecedented mobility on construction sites. The 50B was versatile and capable of being configured as a shovel, crane, dragline, or clamshell. Its historical importance is underlined by its role in various infrastructure projects, including its work in Colorado during the 1950s, where it operated in placer mining until 1978. Today, the Bucyrus Erie 50B is preserved as an artifact of early 20th century engineering at the Netherland Mining Museum in Colorado. The Bucyrus Erie 50B set the standard for mobile heavy-duty excavation. Its rotating design and multiple configurations made it one of the most versatile machines of its era. Its continued use well into the 20th century speaks to its durability and engineering excellence. Introduced in 1946, the Shield Bantam C-35 became a symbol of American industrial growth in the post-war period. With over 15,000 units sold, this cable-operated excavator was known for its reliability and power. It ran on a 110-horsepower Chrysler engine and used a cable system to control its digging arm. The Bantam cable excavator was widely used in construction projects that helped build the post-war American economy. From digging foundations to building roads and highways, it was an important participant in expanding cities and infrastructure. The Bantam C-35 represented the dawn of a new era in construction equipment. Its combination of power and precision made it a favorite among contractors during the post-war construction boom. This machine helped lay the foundation for the rapid urbanization of the mid-20th century. No machine symbolizes industrial progress quite like the steamroller. Originally developed to roll steel plates for boilers, the steamroller quickly found its true calling in road construction. British manufacturers like Aveling and Porter pioneered the use of steamrollers for leveling roads in the late 19th century, and soon these machines were paving the way for the modern world. Steamrollers played a crucial role in building roads, airfields, and agricultural land, creating the infrastructure necessary for modern society. They were a cornerstone of early transportation projects and helped turn dirt roads into paved highways, revolutionizing travel and commerce. The steamroller is an enduring symbol of industrial progress. Its role in building roads and highways made it an essential part of the infrastructure boom of the late 19th and early 20th centuries. Today, preserved steamrollers serve as reminders of how these simple yet powerful machines helped build the modern world. Finally, we come to the Bucyrus rail-mounted steam shovel, a machine that revolutionized railroad construction in the late 19th century. First introduced in 1882, these steam shovels could be mounted on tracks, allowing them to move along a worksite with unprecedented mobility. Powered by steam, these machines were used to dig trenches, move earth, and lay the foundations for railways across the United States. The Bucyrus rail-mounted shovels were instrumental in building the railroads that connected America, making it possible to transport goods and people across vast distances. Their contribution to the Panama Canal Project further solidified their place in history, as these machines helped carve out one of the greatest engineering feats of the 20th century. The Bucyrus rail-mounted steam shovel was a pivotal innovation in railroad and canal construction, transforming how large-scale earth-moving projects were approached. Its ability to traverse rail lines while performing heavy excavation work made it an indispensable tool during the height of industrialization. The heavy machinery of the past wasn't just about moving dirt, it was about moving the world forward. These steam-powered giants laid the groundwork for the modern infrastructure we depend on every day. From the Rust and Hooley steam navvy that dug Britain's quarries, to the Bucyrus shovels that built the Panama Canal, these machines were at the forefront of human progress. Their legacy continues in the machines we use today, and their stories remind us of the invention, innovation, and determination that shaped our world. If you enjoyed this video related to the history of heavy machinery, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more amazing stories of engineering marvels.